waited an eternity for this. It's over, Prime.
Ah, oh, who am I kidding? I did wait an eternity for this figure. Jeez. Oh, hello, my name is Fu Manchu. And you know what? It's true. I've been waiting for this figure since the 80s, man. Seriously, a screen-accurate Megatron? Oh, sign me up for that. But you know what? Kind of reminds me of waiting all this time. Just kind of reminds me of that scene from Back to the Future 2 when Marty receives that letter from Doc Brown. Yeah, I could pretend that I ordered this figure back in the 80s and it took all this time to get to me. It'd be a little something like this.
I've got something for you.
Who the hell are you?
Western Union. So we've had that envelope in our possession for the past 70 years. It was given to us with the explicit instructions that it be delivered to a young man with your description at this exact location, at this exact minute.
So, now that it's traveled all the way through time to get to me, today's review will be on the following! Straight from the planet of bubble wrap. Jeez, this is gonna be hard to review. Okay, I say we remove all this bubble wrap first. Alright, that looks a lot better! Today's review will be on the Takaratomi, the Trans More Than Meets the Eye Formers, a masterpiece figure of MP36 Destron Leader Megatron.
Megatron! Megatron!
That's what I said, Starscream, albeit I didn't say it as manly as you do, but you know what? Hey, check this box out. It looks awesome. I love the way they've got imposed on the front there. That is Megatron through and through. Now, like I said, this is a toy that I have been waiting for years, and I'm so glad that it exists. Honestly, I didn't have a problem with the first Masterpiece Megatron. I thought he looked fine. Yes, there's a lot of people out there that hate on that one, and they hate on this one, and they hate on everything. But you know what? As evil as I am, I can't find anything to hate about a Transformer toy. I mean, I'm happy with all of them. Now, this looks amazing, man, and I cannot wait to see it open. Now, I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm gonna warn you, I am not transforming this figure. I want him in robot mode. I'm not gonna transform him. I know he turns into a gun. Duh, I've got an imagination. I can pretend he's a gun. And you know what? Honestly, I just want him in robot mode, so don't think that I'm gonna transform it. This probably won't be a very in-depth review, but I will compare him to one of the second-party Megatrons that I have, and, you know, we'll show a little comparison to those. But anyways, there's the front of the box looking very awesome indeed, so let's say we look at the back of the box. What do you say? So, here's the back of the box, and you have the Transformers Masterpiece logo there, Megatron's name, and check that out. They actually put how big he is on the back of the box. He's 240 feet tall. Holy cow! I knew he could mass shift, but this is a pretty small box, man. I don't know how he's going to fit in here, but you know what? That is cool. Look, it even says actual size. He better be 240 feet tall. Man, that is awesome. Over here, we've got a picture of him posing like on the front of the box. Very cool indeed. And you've got a bunch of little pictures here. Very neat and very scene-specific. And then down here, it's got a picture of him holding all of his accessories. No, he doesn't come with an Optimus Prime, but hey, if you've got an Optimus, you can put him on there, and that's pretty cool. Down here, you've got all his different faces, and that is so awesome that they did that, especially this last one back here. Oh, man, that is so cool indeed. But yeah, that's the back of the box. It looks pretty cool indeed, and I can't wait to look inside it. But before we do, let's check out the top of the box, shall we? Because it actually has a picture on the top of it, and that's pretty cool. He's got his little lightsaber there. That is awesome indeed. Not to mention, on the bottom of the box, you actually have a picture of all the accessories, and that is pretty cool indeed. I love how they did that. They usually do that on the back of the box, but hey, that's okay. It's a little tiny, but at least you see what's inside there. That is cool. So, that's what the box looks like, and since this figure took 33 years to reach me, I say we waste no more time, and I say we open it! So, here's the figure still in his tray, removed from the box, and check this out. This tray is huge, man. The figure looks kind of small on this tray, but the tray is big, so, I mean, that's going to happen. And if you look carefully, you can see there's another tray actually taped to the bottom of this tray. So, let's remove both of them and see what comes with this figure, shall we? So, here's the smaller tray that's behind the larger tray, and you will see he has some gun extension pieces. He has his laser sword right there, looking very cool indeed. And from what I've heard, you can take that laser beam off of there and put it on the gun that dealt the death blow for Optimus Prime right there, so you can make it look like he's shooting him. He also came with a battle-damaged chest piece, which is awesome. Man, I wish Takara would basically make an entire battle-damaged version of Megatron looking like this, and Optimus. That would be amazing. You've got his mind control helmet there that he controlled the double Optimus Prime or whatever. And then you've got three extra faces right there. You got the battle-damaged one, a laughing one, and a yelling one. And that is awesome. And what the heck? Look at that! I got two laughing faces! Holy cow, I didn't get the tragedy of the comedy and tragedy set! That sucks, man! So yeah, apparently, I got two of the same faces. So I'm glad you saw that when I did, because I almost missed that. What the heck, man? But yeah, apparently I'm missing a face. Now, this is the one I wanted the absolute most, and I really hope the other Megatron toy didn't come with one of these equipped, because then I'll have three of them. Holy cow, man! But yeah, apparently I'm missing a face. That really sucks. But oh well, I'll see what'll happen. Maybe I can contact the seller and, I don't know. But you know what? That's okay. I think it's funny. Over here, we've got the key to Vector Sigma. We've got his gun extension right there, and then his the stock of the gun. You've got his spiked mace ball thing with the actual plastic chain there, and then a chain for posing right there, and that is pretty awesome indeed. Yeah, this is really awesome, but you know what? That is funny. I got two laughing Megatron faces. If I'd have gotten one more, I'd have won some cherries or some coins or something, because of three of the kind, that's pretty good. That's weird, man. As for the larger of the two trays, you got Megatron himself looking very awesome indeed, and thankfully I didn't get another laughing face, and you also get his fusion cannon, which looks amazing. Now, upon looking at this figure for the first time, he does look smaller than I thought he would be. I don't know, there's just something about it, he just seems a little small, but I guarantee you it's because, check out this plastic bubble, it's huge, man. I'm sure when I stand him up next to my other Masterpiece Transformers, he'll look fine, but you know what, he just looks small inside this bubble. So I say we waste no more time, and I say we stand him up, what do you say? So, here's Megatron fresh out of the package, and he looks awesome! Check him out. Look, I didn't get another laughing face. Whew, thank goodness. This is the face I wanted the most on my Megatron. This just normal, you know, static-looking face. But, so I'm glad I got this one. But I did want the yelling face, too. Man, that kind of sucks not to get it. But you know what? This figure looks really cool. I do say feels a little small, but that's alright. I mean, seriously, it's because you hold a figure like Ultra Magnus and he's huge. But this figure, of course, would be in scale with that, and Megatron wasn't as big as Ultra Magnus. Now, this looks very, very awesome indeed. All these little panel lines and stuff on it, though, remind me of the Titanium series toys. I don't know, there's just something about it, it just reminds me of that. I kind of wish they weren't there, but I understand, it's a toy and it has to transform into a gun. And I think it looks awesome. But speaking of which, there's a lot of people out there that would think this looks less than awesome. I mean, look at all those little, like, things on his back, and oh my god. But you know what, yeah, it doesn't look as clean as it could look, but it's a toy and it has to transform into a gun, I get it. Other, you know, third-party people have probably done it better. But, hey, look, you wanted an official Megatron, here's the official Megatron. If you don't like it, go buy one of the knockoff ones, because those are just as good. They look awesome. I don't know why you'd complain. You've got a bunch of Megatrons to choose from. Now, yeah, this should look better back here, but you know what? In person, it doesn't look that bad. Besides, who's going to pose their Megatron facing this direction anyway? Now, that's not to say that Takara couldn't have done it better, and you know what? Chances are they're gonna do it better like three or four times down the road, because this is probably not the last Masterpiece Transformer of Megatron we will ever see. So you know what? Just enjoy this one while you got it. I think it is awesome, and I'm so happy that I was able to get it, because I didn't think I would be able to get it. Now, I actually have one of the third-party Megatrons still in my collection. I actually had Apollyon there for a long time, and I thought he looked awesome. Until I got Mitron. And then when I got Mitron and stood them next to Apollyon, yeah, I quickly got rid of Apollyon. He just didn't look as cool or beefy or intimidating as Mitron looked. Now the question is, how does this one stack up against Mitron? Let's find out, shall we? Now, Now, you tell me which one you like better. I think this one is a really nice Megatron masterpiece figure. There are people out there that complain about the legs, and I'm like, seriously? That's what you're going to complain about? His legs? Look at this part up here. He looks fine. What the heck, man? But you know what? This figure, it really is beefy. He's got the shiny silver, you know, color and stuff like that. He looks really awesome. He's not quite as shiny as Apollyon, but I thought Apollyon was too shiny. That was too G1 toy accurate. This one right here I thought looks good, like it would look like on the toy if he was in real life. He'd be probably, you know, silver and stuff like that. This looks fine. It's not too reflective. It's not too shiny. It looks good to me. Plus, if you look at his back, when he came out, there was a lot of people complaining about this backpack thing, too. Now, I probably got mine mistransformed. This is just how I've had him on the shelf or whatever. Now, this figure is amazing. I think it looks good. His legs look a lot better than Apollyon's did and stuff like that. The Apollyon just seemed a little rickety, like it would, you know, you could touch it and all pieces would just start unlatching and stuff. They didn't really hook in. This one looks really good, especially compared to that. I've heard a lot of people, you know, like Apollyon more than this one. Hey, more power to you. There's Megatrons for everybody. And now there's a new and improved MP Megatron. Now, let's see how he looks standing next to my Tron. And as you can see, he's not as small as he felt when I first opened this box. Now, in comparison, yes, Mitron has a bigger chest, he's got bigger arms and stuff like that, but he's a beefier figure. Now, the MP Megatron over here, yeah, he does look a little smaller, but he's taller, his head's bigger, that's for sure. I think it looks really good. I think both in your collection, if you had either of them, I think you'd be happy with either of these figures, or Apollyon, if you like that one. And you know what, honestly, I think you get a good Megatron no matter which figure you get. I think it looks awesome. Now, over to this one. They did make him really gray. Now, I don't know. He seems a little dark. The character on the cartoon was colored gray and stuff like that, but I always took it as he was supposed to be silver, but, you know, hey, whatever. This looks good. It doesn't look that bad. It's not so dark that it's, you know, not right. I think he looks fine. I do kind of wish they'd have went with this color, but honestly, it doesn't matter. It looks fine by me. Now, which do you like better? I don't know, man. This is a really hard one because, you know, people have said, if you look at this one, would you think that's the masterpiece or would you think this is the third-party figure? That's a tough one because seeing both of these together, yeah, I don't know. I might lean towards this one looking more like the masterpiece, but I still like things about the... I don't know, man! This is hard. But, you know, like I said, there's a bunch of Megatrons out there. You can choose the one you want, and honestly, if you get more than one and you have two or three in your collection, hey, if you can do that, cool. I've got these two, and I thought I might be getting rid of him. But you know what? I don't know. I might keep him because he still looks awesome. This is very cool indeed. So I say we waste no more time, and I say we look at this guy up close. What do you say? So here we go with a super-duper close-up look. And as you can see, this is an animation-style Decepticon symbol. Now, I really like that they're doing that to make these look more cartoon accurate. But I do wish, just like the Battle Damage chest plate, I wish he came with a different one to have the more, you know, normal, streamlined Decepticon symbol. Because this is obviously, like I said, the cartoon version, like it was hand-drawn or something like that. But you know what? I do wish it came with the option, because I think it would make it fit in better to your collection, because a lot of the other ones have, like, the normal Autobot and Decepticon symbols. So yeah, I do wish you had the option, but oh well, whatever. Now as you can see, he's actually metal flaked colored, and you know, that's something you really can't tell looking at it with the naked eye. It actually does look metal flaked, and that is awesome. He's got some little vents there on his chest, very cool indeed. I love how he's got the little like headlight window things there, because those always like flashed when he would get a signal in or whatever, get a call in, and they'd start flashing. I think that's very cool indeed. A lot of people have complained about all this stuff up here at the top, but you know, that's due to transformation. I get it. I'm not going to complain about something like that, because obviously, I know, they could have done better, but you know what? I don't care. The only way to make this figure probably as best as it possibly could would be to make a non-transforming Transformer figure, and I'd have no problem with Transformers action figures. Honestly, I wouldn't have a problem with that at all, but at least we have the option of changing him into a gun if we want to. Now, there's his mouth looking very cool indeed. As you can see, they actually painted the black line inside of his mouth. That's very cool. Check out his eyes, man. They're shiny and reflective, and that is very cool indeed. Yeah, that's Megatron through and through, and that looks awesome. They got his head absolutely perfect. Whether, you know, you like the figure or not, based on the transformation, you know, lines and stuff like that. You gotta admit, his face looks awesome. Now, working our way down his arm here, you can see a lot of the panel lines there. I don't know how big the red was in the cartoon. I thought it was supposed to be a little bigger than that, but that looks fine. And then down here, you got his arm and his hand and all his little jointed fingers and stuff, and that is pretty cool indeed. Working our way down to his abs, I love all these little clear pieces that are colored. That looks so cool indeed. Now that makes him look fancy. He's got some circuitry and stuff like that underneath there, and that is very cool indeed. Now that's a detail I really, really like. That is awesome. Here's his crotch plate or whatever. It's got a lot of panel lines too, but that's so you can articulate him. And then down here, it almost looks like he has landing gear that would come out of his leg right there. That's kind of neat. And then down here, you've got his legs that a lot of people complained about on Mitron. But you know what? They look pretty good on this one. And I believe his legs down here are die-cast metal. And that's pretty cool. Now, I don't really care if it has die-cast in it. But this is a pretty light figure. So, you know, getting a little bit of weight with him, that's pretty cool. And then right here, you've got his fusion cannon looking very scopey. And then I love how that's painted red. And if you push this button right wherever the button is. Where's the button? Where's the button? It's not that. That's a little switch. You switch that back and forth. And then you push that button right there. And he speaks in Japanese with the Megatron voice. He makes a laser sound that does not sound like his laser sound from the cartoon. And he also makes a transforming and transforming back noise. And that's pretty cool indeed. It does not light up. A lot of people have said, why doesn't it light up? That's true, because most of the third-party ones did light up. It's weird that this one doesn't, but I think we just got spoiled on the third-party ones. That is still awesome. As for his accessories, here's the battle damage chest plate, and that looks amazing. I love the way that Decepticon symbol is shredded there on his chest. He's got all the little dents and stuff, and these little clear windows here are actually cracked like a light, you know, like a headlight would be. And that is so cool indeed. Man, that's a touch right there that they didn't need to do, but they did, and that is awesome. Yeah, I love this chest plate, and like I said, I really wish that they would make a completely battle-damaged Megatron like this and a damaged Optimus. They don't have to transform, in my opinion. Just to have them on the shelf would be amazing. Now, here's his laser sword right here. Very cool indeed. That looks awesome and very screen accurate. You've got the little ball right there with the laser coming out of it. And a lot of people complain about the little air bubbles that are trapped inside there. But honestly, come on, man, it's a toy. I get it. You know, you spend a lot of money on these things. You want them to be perfect. But it's the luck of the draw, man. You just get what you get. And that's pretty cool. As for the other weapon that he used against Optimus Prime, you got his little laser gun right here. Very cool indeed. Yeah, he just found weapons laying all over the place, huh? It was a battlefield, so I guess that's why. But man, oh man, that looks awesome. Above that, you have the jointed chain that you can replace the other chain with. And this way you can have him posing with the chain, you know, kind of like swinging in the air. Or you can just have this chain right here that just kind of dangles or whatever. You can have the ball just kind of dangling on the ground. I do wish they'd have painted this a little bit. I mean, I understand that it's supposed to be clear energy, but you can see through it. That's no big deal, though. I mean, that's a nitpick. You also get the key to Vector Sigma, which is very cool indeed. And, you know, I think I got this with another one of the toys that I got a long time ago. Can't remember. I remember it came with actually the little cardboard thing, the Vector Sigma cardboard thing. So, I don't know. I think I already have this. But you know what? Still pretty cool. And you know, from what I hear, I think this is die-cast metal. And that is pretty awesome indeed. You also get his little mind control Optimus Prime helmet thingamabobber, and that's pretty awesome indeed. Yeah, that's cool. And this came with a couple of the third-party ones, too. And you know what? This looks just like the ones that came with that. That's still awesome, and I think it's cool that it came with it. You also get his Transformers the Movie battle-damaged face. And man, oh man, this is awesome. Like I said, I really wish that they would make a totally battle-damaged Megatron and totally battle-damaged Optimus. This would be so cool, and I absolutely love that they made this face. I mean, check that out. They didn't just paint the lines on there, man. He's all dented to pieces. He looks amazing, and I love that expression on his face. He's saying, it's over, Prime. And up here we have a laughing face, and above that we have another laughing face. Hey, I got the laughing twins. The Bobsit twins, apparently. But yeah, I love how they painted his eyes. These faces look amazing, even though they're identical. I mean, kind of sucks that I got two. I would have liked to have had that shouting face. But, oh well, luck of the draw. I got this one, at least, and I'm happy. Oh, and you might have noticed, by the way, that my gun silencer thingamabobber thing, the extension here, doesn't have the orange cap, neither does Megatron, so at least I got one that doesn't have the silly orange thing, because I would just have to take that off, and I've heard a lot of people are having problems with, like, paint coming off and junk like that, and you know what? I'm happy that I didn't get it like that. That is awesome. Oh, and he also came with some instructions, as you can see, a big old book of instructions. He's got a little card in there, and that is cool indeed. Yeah, this will come in handy for anybody who wants to turn him into a gun, and I do not envy you. I'm leaving mine in robot mode because, you know what, I'm not putting in that much work to make him into a gun. This is still cool, though. Besides, this is how I want to display my Megatron, and I think he looks amazing. Now, the question is he worth getting? Well, I'm very glad that I got him because I think he looks amazing. And like I said, this one's light years beyond the first version of Megatron that the Masterpiece, you know, line created. Now, if you have one of the other third-party Megatrons, do you need to get this one? No, I don't think you do because I think they're all pretty similar. I mean, honestly, if you look right there at his gun, that little, like, I don't know, that hexagonal shape and that little circle with the Ghostbuster symbol through it, and you compare it to a third-party one like Mitron here. I mean, seriously, does it matter? I mean, they look so similar. Honestly, if you have this one here, you're going to be happy with it. If you have Apollyon, if you're happy with that one, you're happy with that one. Honestly, there's not much difference. It all comes down to personal taste. And, you know, honestly, if you want this one because he's a licensed, you know, Megatron, hey, there you go. You got a licensed Megatron right there. If you want one that looks better than this one, hey, go for one of the other ones. Just whatever makes you happy. Stop complaining because we don't want companies like this to stop making these figures, do we? I mean, jeez, just stop complaining, people. God, just be happy with what you can get. You've got, like, what, four or five different Masterpiece Transformers of Megatron out there that you can buy from, and you're over there griping that one's not perfect, or this one's not perfect, or blah, blah, blah. You know what? Seriously, just like them for what they are. Toys of Megatron. And honestly, does it get any better than that? So, there's my review of the Transformers Masterpiece MP36 Megatron! And you know what? He looks amazing and I absolutely love him. And you know what? This figure is so cool and I recommend it to anybody who wants it. And honestly, if you don't want it, you want to keep your third-party one? Hey, seriously? More power to you because those are just as cool. So, until next time, tune in for more Foo Reviews! Come here, Fuzzbug. Come on, come on. Hey, join me in a Megatron laugh. Are you ready? Here we go. Oh, you didn't do it. Man, Fuzzbug, you're going to have to turn in your evil card.
Hey, this is Nolan North. You don't want to miss Foo Reviews. And I'm out.